Good morning, sports fans. Welcome to the Cheap Seats on 96.3 FM. Scott Kirby, Joe Ryan, Jake Johnston with you this morning.
Jake, a late arrival today.
He's on Joe time.
I wasn't even close to Joe time.
Oh,
I was here like 48.
No. You came in here like you had just got off a horse and a rodeo.
7 minutes.
Yeah.
It took me about 7 minutes to figure out where the coffee and everything was. So.
You walked right by it.
No, I was up there making it. I put a combination in there.
Combo. We are at Joe Ryan Country Financial on this.
An excellent day to get some insurance.
Good morning, sports fans.
If you need insurance, come see Joe Monday through Friday from 11:30 to 12.
Because you need life insurance.
On there a hot day like this, you know, you may just need it.
Yeah. Hey, let's talk about the weather. You guys think it's hot out?
No.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it's pretty hot.
Well, yeah, this is a good day to be a lifeguard. Making money, getting the sun, tanned up. Were you guys ever lifeguards?
No.
I swim. Can either one of you guys swim?
Swim like a rock.
You guys look like a couple of floaters to me.
Oh, yeah?
Listen to Joe.
Yeah.
Sorry, that was just funny.
Joe.
I'm going to be good. You know what I mean? I don't want to say anything negative towards you two.
I saw you working out.
Management told me not to say anything to you two about your weight and stuff, so I'm going to quit.
You're right there with us, buddy.
I was going to say, he was working hard, but it didn't look like much was going on.
Yeah, you know what? Age takes its toll on you.
You have taken a toll. Mark Grote, Chicago Cubs radio broadcaster, pregame, postgame, will be calling in about 9:20. So we'll talk with Mark.
He's going to bring his ratchet.
He might bring his ratchet.
Jim's going to ask him about it.
So, Jim, get ready for the bleep button. So he'll be calling at 9:20. We'll talk some Cubs baseball with him. Cubs win last night. The Cards win last night. We do have a trivia. Phone lines are open. 737-3791.
You printed a trivia out?
Quit. You know he didn't do it.
No. Oh, that makes sense. Maybe he put a whole bunch of big words in it?
So I could read. No, it's
Is
pretty.
Is there anything to do with fish?
No.
Gomer Pyle.
It's too late.
But trivia question is, on Wednesday, Sung Hwan Ho.
Can you go through that again?
Sung Hwan Ho.
That's Ho Chi Minh.
He became the first Cardinal closer since 2004 to save both games of a doubleheader. Who was the pitcher in 2004 to save both games of a doubleheader?
Wow. That's a great question.
That is not a great question.
It is because
it works. People should know it.
Do you have a question?
Yeah.
Because we got
no,
some
people
other
people should
stuff.
Know it.
Oh, well,
that's we want them to win.
Yeah.
We want them to win.
Well, usually they have to Google it. This shouldn't be a Google. This shouldn't even be Googled.
Well, I would have had to.
You know.
Would you?
Whatever happened to doubleheaders?
They still have them.
Not like they used to.
Well, they don't schedule them.
They're split doubleheaders now, so that way they can get the double fares.
Right. Yeah.
Used to be you pay
used to be
one.
Cool when you had a doubleheader, man. That was cool. They'd
watch baseball all day long.
You go to Wrigley for $6 and sit in the bleachers and watch a doubleheader. That's incredible.
Let's play two.
When was that? 1920?
1928 and 29. I was 10. It was a long time ago, but I did it.
I've done it.
$6. You can't even buy a hot dog for $6.
No, it was incredible. Yeah,
would you get a hot dog for 15 cents?
I couldn't afford one.
Couldn't afford it?
No.
So who was the pitcher in 2004 to save both games of a doubleheader? Jake says
2004 was a great year by the Cardinals. They should have won the World Series that year. They were the best team in baseball. They just, I tell you what, they ran into the Red Sox, and that was the hottest team I think maybe in the history of World Series baseball. Yeah. I mean, they're down 3-0 to the Yankees, stormed back, won next four, and then won the next four against Cardinals.
They were hot,
That one of the hottest teams in playoff history, in my opinion.
Oh, yeah?
That's when they went at home two and then came to St. Louis and won two.
Won two, yeah.
And that's when I had World Series tickets for both games. And let my mom and dad and I think Pee Wee and Marty went, and I just said I'd go to game five. And they got beat, and I didn't get to go.
I tell you, that's
funny.
That Red Sox team, they were fun to watch. They were definitely a team of destiny there.
Yes, they were.
Team of Destiny.
Team of Destiny.
Reminds me of one of your favorite bands, Destiny's Child. You have a song you like
that
to play from.
That is one of his favorites.
How'd you know, Joe?
Because I see you over here playing the drums to it all the time.
Is that why you were cranking it this morning while we were...
Destiny's Child.
On your old radio machine?
Radio machine. That's what it's called.
This well-tuned show here.
I'll tell you what, I've been eating a lot of that stuff from the Hampton Inn. Delicious.
Yeah,
Hampton Inn pastries and
the eggs,
the omelets, the potatoes.
And you know, I'm gonna give a little hats off.
Omelets.
There's, I'm gonna give a little hats off to Jeff number two for making that happen.
Yeah,
he gets that stuff out here. I wonder if he's listening. Maybe he'd give us a call, Ed.
Hats off.
There it is. I think he's got a new jingle going.
That was kind of lame.
Well, he kept his head down during it, too.
They've all been lame.
No, he's had a couple of good ones. I think last week's was good.
They're funny.
They're fine. Now, I mean, we need to get Lloyd on there just to tell him the day in the life of Lloyd Kirby. What does Lloyd Kirby do? I mean,
why doesn't he have his own headset
sure
where he can
like
just chime in?
Yes.
You are correct, sir.
McMahon.
Phone number is 737-3791 if you want to call for the with the answer.
You have to call with the answer? Is that what we're saying?
Yeah.
You're have blowing to call. Us up.
Two tickets tonight.
Paradise?
I guess we should say what you're going to win. Two tickets, nice action park. That's $70 value.
That's
yeah,
paradise.
You're calling for those things.
Yeah.
You're not
yeah.
texting or tweeting.
You call
it.
In and be a winner.
No. We're going to give out another
one
here.
What's the phone number? You better say the phone number.
737-3791.
There we go.
737-3791. Everybody should have that.
They should all. It should already be plugged into their phone.
Yeah. Contacts. When you
just hit the thing.
Hit.
Sports show.
Yeah.
Boom.
Cheap seats.
Cheap seats.
Pull right up. We do have a free cheeseburger and one free cone from McDonald's that we're going to have a question for. And that one, you can tweet it. You can tweet the answer. So as soon as Jake gives out the question.
Jake's in charge of the question?
Yeah.
And we hopefully will have it before the end of the show.
He says this one's too easy. So
well, maybe not.
He's going to make you earn.
Where's Pooley at? You know Pooley knows the answer to this. Where's he at? Sleeping?
Yeah.
Hang on.
Pooley. Pooley should know this answer. Where's he at? Hiding.
And we got a caller on the line right now with the answer. Go ahead, caller.
Well, if you're going to just give it away, it was Isringhausen.
Well, that's what
there
we do.
You go.
We give things away out here.
Why wouldn't we?
Isringhausen.
I was starting to think that I was the only one that listened to the show because no one ever calls in. And then I thought to myself, I don't even know the number. I'm like, I don't even think they ever even give out the number.
No, we give her out all the time.
Really? Well,
I'll say you're welcome for that.
Well, I appreciate it. Do I pick those up at Jake's?
Yeah, you can pick them up at Jake's.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Right. Put your swimsuit on and go enjoy a hot day at Knights Action Park.
It's a good day for it. Do it today.
Hey, I went last year.
Yeah.
Thanks to you guys. So it was all right.
Well, we're glad to help you out.
Today's a good day for it.
It is.
Say hi, Jason Washington.
Today.
Yeah.
No, not today.
Hey, don't.
I see a red lobster.
You better find Jason Washington and go to the other end of the pool.
That's why Jake doesn't go anymore.
Yeah, well,
Jake used to be a regular.
Save me. It'll take two or three lifeguards to pull me out, so I'm hoping nothing ever happens.
All right, well, Steve, thanks for calling in, buddy. Congratulations.
See ya. Thanks.
Yep. Steve Ferris, the big winner of the Knights Action Park tickets. Jason Isringhausen, 2004.
Yeah. I tell you, that was a great team.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think they won. What'd they win? 104? 105 games?
105 games, but didn't finish it.
That was that the year they got rolling, or did they get rolling the year before?
Okay. They got Walker that year.
They got Larry Walker. Okay, yeah.
See, Jim knows.
I'll tell you what. Yeah, he's good at this, isn't he?
Yeah.
We know what he does in his free time. Still trying to figure out Loin's free time.
Well, Loin's a jingle.
We're actually trying to figure out his work time.
We're trying to figure out his occupation. What's he do?
With a shrug of the shoulders?
I don't know what I do.
I
create jingles is what I do. But you got a question for us yet, Jake? We're gonna.
Oh, did you want?
Well, we got a cheeseburger and a free cone to give away from McDonald's, and
I can come up with something.
We're gonna. You can tweet the answer for these.
All right. So, how did the Cardinals game end last night? 16 innings.
That's too easy.
It's
the phone lines are lighting up.
It's an ice cream cone and a cheeseburger.
What? A cheeseburger?
Cheeseburger.
Burger.
Is that the question, really?
Sure.
All right. What was the question?
Yeah.
How did the Cardinals game end last night?
Like final score?
No, How did the end?
What was the outcome of the game?
What was the end?
You can tweet that.
Cubs
to
fans
us at WLCN
part.
Sports.
What if they don't tweet?
Well,
they can tweet, they can call.
You can call the phone number.
Yeah, you tweet. Yeah, you call. Can call.
The phone number is
7-3-7-7-3-7-3-7-9-9-1-3-7-3-7-3-7-9-1.
You can call that in for a chance to win a
cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger and a cone.
That was pretty funny. You're a pretty funny guy.
A cheeseburger and a cone.
And a cone. Yes. Ice cream cone. You can fill it, I guess, with anything you want.
We need you to figure out how to do Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump. That's what we need to have for the next year or so.
That'd be huge.
Yeah. Somebody on here needs to be able to do that. Let's work on that.
Okay. You be Hillary.
I was going to say.
You have a higher voice anyway.
I was like, you're a perfect Hillary.
Oh, yeah. Whatever. Well, hey, let's take a break. It's 9:15. We come back. We're going to have Mark Grote on the line. We're going to talk some Cubs baseball.
Let's hope we still have some listeners around out there.
Oh, well, they're tuning in right now.
Cardinal fans are turning off.
That's Mark Grody's coming on. So, yeah.
All right. Stay tuned. You're in the Cheap Seats on 96.3 FM.
Don't ever put that on here.
What?
You playing the drums?
Oh.
And we're back.
We are back. Cheap Seats 96.3 FM. Streaming live on the web at WLCNonline.com. Jake Johnston, Joe Ryan, Scott Kirby with you this morning. And on the line right now, we have Chicago Cubs pregame, postgame broadcaster Mark Grody. Good morning, Mark.
Morning, guys. What's happening in Lincoln and Atlanta and all those great central Illinois
cities? Well, sun, that's what's happening.
The sun. It's blistering hot. How's the weather up there in Milwaukee?
Same. Yeah, it was about, I think it was 88 degrees at game time last night. And one thing I didn't realize is that even when you're in a dome or a retractable potential situation as you are at Miller Park, they don't have air conditioning when they close the roof there. So the roof open situation.
Oh boy.
I didn't realize. I just assumed, honestly, like maybe I'm just stupid, but I thought all domes had air conditioning.
I guess it wasn't in the budget.
I thought they had air conditioning. I've been there like five, six times and never noticed. I guess it was one time it was freezing cold, snowing outside, so felt good inside.
Well, Mark, the Cubs are back on their winning ways right there before All-Star break. They had about a 2-3 week span there where they weren't playing real good baseball. Played 24 games in 24 days, didn't have a break. But now it seems that they're rejuvenated and hopefully they can go on another run here.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, yeah, they did not look good for about 3 weeks or so, as you indicated before. The All-Star break was downright bad at times, especially in that series in New York where they got swept by the Mets and, John Lester was out before the second inning was over. And none of the starting pitchers were looking good. And, it's been a really encouraging start to the second half. You take 2 out of 3 from a pretty good Texas team, actually a very good Texas team, and then I would put the pretty part on the Mets, a pretty good Mets team too, from whom you took 2 out of 3 as well. And, the best, I think maybe the single best part of the Cubs' recent improvement or returning to what they were at the beginning of the year is that Jake Arrieta seems to have gotten, at least in one start, seems to have gotten back to a semblance of the dominance that we had come to expect from him, whereas he had 3 kind of dud outings where everybody was a little bit you know, concerned. I don't think anybody thought that that he was going to ever return to his historic type performances. But if you're going to, if the Cubs are to go to the postseason and be successful in it, they're going to need Jake Arrieta to pitch like an ace.
And is it true that after Lester's short outing there in New York, that he went to that Broadway show? What was it, Hamilton?
I am not sure.
I'm just starting a rumor. I don't know if that's what happened or not.
I cannot verify that sort of rumor here, but I don't know. Hey, if he did, you know, it seems to have soothed him a little bit.
It's a hot ticket.
why wouldn't you?
So, you know, with the Cubs off to the hot start they were at, and, you know, Jake Arrieta just pitching out of his mind, you know, they're going to have some struggles, and, you know, you want to have those struggles just to see what kind of team you have. So maybe, you know, that little span, you know, kind of woke them up a little bit, and, you know, now they see what they need to work on. The trade deadline is, about 7-8 days? What's the buzz going around the clubhouse as far as, you know, we just signed a pitcher from Seattle, Montgomery. What is the buzz about any other possible signings or trades?
Yeah, I mean, that's a great question. I mean, the Montgomery signing, surprised me a little bit, just in terms of, like, I didn't know that name, I hadn't heard that being kicked around much, but it looks like from everything that I've seen and been able to observe that it's a pretty good deal and a guy who you could get some serious value out of in Mike Montgomery. Now, moving forward, I still think that they probably will look to continue to fortify the bullpen in that middle relief spot. And I wouldn't mind them seeing them pull off a deal, honestly, for another starting pitcher. And I know that sounds kind of crazy because the starting rotation has been very good this year in general. But I think it would serve two purposes. If you were to acquire another starter, you have a guy who, just in case there's something bad happens with one of the starters, whether one of them begins to struggle or one of them gets injured, you have that guy. You can do the six-man rotation occasionally if you'd like to. And then, come postseason time, you have another arm that you might be able to bring out of the bullpen, whether it's that guy, the mystery man that you bring in, or one of the other five guys in the rotation, because you know that's how it works in the playoffs. So we see weird things where you see starters going on short rest and you see starters coming in out of the bullpen. It's all hands on deck, no holding back. So to me, I think that I would love to keep it to the ground and get another starter. Remote possibility of another bat. I mean, I think you guys have probably heard Josh Reddick's name thrown out there. I think that's a possibility to get him for the right price. They're not going to overpay for somebody like that. He's a free agent after this year. So, you know, there's no way they're going to give up any kind of blockbuster prospects for a rental player who would, in essence, be a platoon player. So that those are all kinds of things that are shaking around, but there's nothing concrete at this point.
Well, there's a lot of pieces to the puzzle, and it just seems like there's not enough room for all these players. We get Dexter Fowler back in the lineup last night. They sent Almora Jr. back down to AAA. Fowler picks up where he left off. First at bat, coming back, hits a homer. He has a double, a single. What was he, 3-for-3 or 4-for-4 last night?
Yeah, he was 3-for-4 with
3-for-4.
Two runs. He was a triple shy of the cycle, and I laugh because it's almost just like too perfect of a story, right?
Yeah.
I mean, Dexter Fowler is this guy who was having an MVP season to start. He goes on the injured list, or, you know, the Cubs start to slump. You know, who knows if there's actually a correlation with the Cubs slumping and Dexter Fowler being out, and he comes back, and they probably don't win last. Well, I mean, maybe they would last night without Fowler, but, I mean, he drove in 3 of their 5 runs. So,
right.
Yeah, I mean, it just is really good to have that guy back at the top of your lineup.
If you were to pick, you know, what you think the Cubs need to make this stretch, what would you say they would look for?
In terms of, like, acquiring somebody at this trade deadline?
Yeah, opinion.
Yeah, well, in my opinion, honestly, like I'm sticking with the idea of a starting pitcher. I mean, that's and I wish I could do a better job of naming names, you know, saying who they would have a realistic possibility of getting. I mean, Chris Archer is one possibility from Tampa Bay. And he's had a bad year. This thought of a bad year is the right way to characterize it. A down year. For a talented young pitcher who I believe is probably under control for years to come still. So that'd be a big prospect
dump, though, for the Cubs, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I mean, if I was Tampa Bay, I mean, you'd have to be silly not to be asking for some serious prospects. But in that case, it might be worthwhile. I mean, really, I mean, you have a lot of repetition on the big league club right now. And you have, one of their hot prospects is either the Padres and then Gleyber Torres. He's their hot shot shortstop prospect. Mm-hmm. I mean, where's the room on the Cubs infield right now?
Right.
I mean, it really isn't much. I mean, you have Javier Baez fighting for playing time. He could be starting on a whole lot of teams. So if you gave up some of those, some of those hot shot prospects that are on the come, I think that eventually you're going to have to give some of those guys up if you want to continue to build. Because really, I mean, you have to look ahead too, because I mean, starting pitching is getting older. Jake Arrieta's a free agent after next year. John Lester's not getting any younger, nor is Jason Hamill. So as good as these guys are now, a couple, two, 3 years down the road, they're all going to be gone.
And short life.
And not only that, but that window, you never know what your window is in baseball. And this season, they're proven to be right there. I feel that they still need pieces. I think they do need more bullpen depth. A starting pitcher would be great, or a guy that can do a long relief type situation to take some stress innings off these guys. But I think they're needing help before they get to the playoffs, just to get them there in a full health situation to where they could be that dominant team like we saw at the very beginning of the season. It's getting, some of these guys are going to get a little long in the tooth, I think, just like they were right before the All-Star break.
Yeah, and honestly, I think that there is, you talk about, going forward this season, and I think that there is, and I do think the Cubs are going to be good for a lot of years to come, but I think that there should be some particular urgency put into this season, because I don't think the regular seasons are going to be as easy ever again, because I think the Cardinals and Pirates are going to be back next year. You see what the Pirates are doing. They've kind of rebuilt their starting staff with some young, really good arms. They've got some young players coming up to mix in with the veterans. The Pirates are not rebuilding. They're going to be back. We'll see what the Cardinals are doing. I mean, they're still hanging around this year, for that matter. And then there's even teams like the team that the Cubs are playing right now, Milwaukee and Cincinnati, who are bad teams who are not interested in being good now, but who knows when they will be interested in being good, and it could be next year, maybe the year after. There's all these teams that are bad right now in the National League that are going to be good and competitive. So I think that this is a year where the Cubs have the clearest path to a potential playoff run and a potential World Series run, where they don't think it'll be easy in years to come. So if there's ever a sacred year, I think it's this one.
I think you're right. This is the year. The Cubs have to do it this year.
They have to.
That's it. They have to do it this year.
Well, I mean, in baseball, I mean, that window, you could go into the preseason next year, right. Two guys get hurt with some serious injury, all of a sudden a complete season can be down the drain like that. That's my only thinking is, why not? It's hot right now. The teams in front of you, and what I mean by in front of you, they I think are direct competitors to you right now. You got Washington, you got New York, you've got L.A. And San Francisco. Those are the teams, and you got to compare your rosters to theirs. Well, you can't compare your roster to them as a season team. You need to compare them as a playoff team. Once you start doing that, I tell you what, San Francisco looks mean. They look tough on paper, especially you get them into the playoffs with a short season like that. You look at New York, man, they're scary. And Washington's right there too, and LA's not going to be afraid to, they're not going to be afraid to throw money out there. So that's what I'm saying. If you have a chance right now to say, okay, we've got to give up these three guys, but we're getting this stud, we're going to get this guy, and we're going to get another guy that's going to lock this up. Right now, I think you need to do it. In my mind, the Cubs have one of the stronger position player farm system still in the system, and there is a log jam there, so unload them and get you guys a World Series.
Add on where you can. I mean, I still think that pound for pound, the Cubs have the least flaws, I think, of any team in Major League Baseball. I mean, there's teams that have caught the Cubs, and it's crapshoot once you get to the postseason.
Strikeout heavy for a playoff team, though.
No, there's no doubt about it. But I think they knew that when they built this team, and they have found ways to to overcome that. And obviously, the part of, you know, and I realize that Jason Hayward signing has not worked out quite yet the way people wanted to, but that was part of the signing of Jason Hayward and Ben Zobrist to have a couple of better plate approach guys, better contact guys. But we've seen, as high as the strikeouts have been, we've seen some really good at-bats from a lot of these Cubs, even the strikeout guys. You know, with Chris Bryant working some brilliant plate appearances, Dexter Fowler, who we've talked about a lot already here today, Anthony Rizzo, man, he had that at-bat last week where he fouled off, you know, 5 2-2 count pitches and then slugged a three-run homer against the lefty Stephen Bass in the Mets. So even though they strike out a lot, they are running up pitch counts this year way better than they did last year, and they have other ways of compensating for their weaknesses, which they knew they were going to have to do.
You say running pitch counts. Does that? Do you want to see them maybe be a little more aggressive? Because to me, it seems like the umpire, the strike zone is kind of inconsistent. Take, for instance, last night. You know, there were some questionable calls right there. And if you go up and you try to work a count, sometimes that's not going to be in your favor.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great point. And I think maybe you base it on kind of get a feel for the game early with whoever the umpire is and get an idea what a strike zone is. Maybe the first time through the order, you are looking at it with that, you know, work the count 2-2-3-2. But if you're not getting those pitches, then I guess too bad for the hitters that right. Those guys got to go ahead and adjust against the umpires. I think for the most part, that philosophy of working on the pitch count has worked for the Cubs. I know that against some of the power pitchers this year and some of the ace-type guys, the Cubs have come out a little bit more aggressively because you're only going to get so many good pitchers against those guys. And I think it's sort of like, all bets are off. I was encouraged by the way they batted against Noah Syndergaard the other day.
Yeah,
that they made solid time. And Syndergaard still had a pretty decent game, but they were making contact against him, solid contact. And to me, that was encouraging because those are the dudes that you're going to have to beat once the postseason comes. And we all know what happened to the Cubs against the Mets last year in that power-type fiction, which mm-hmm. in general, I think the Cubs have kind of struggled against.
Yeah, and, you know, they left, I think, at least 9 guys on base the first, what, 3 or 4 innings. You know, we had our opportunities yeah. against Syndergaard and just couldn't get that clutch hit with runners on base.
Yeah, I mean, I noted all those, too, but at the same time, I was like, you know, this kind of sucks they're not getting these guys in, but I'm encouraged that they're making such good contact. They're not just whiffing left and right.
Right.
You know, as a baseball fan, I mean, I'm a Cardinal fan, you know that, but I'm cheering for these
yes,
Cubbies.
Yes, we do know that, Joe.
So, what was it? Was it Tuesday night when Ariota hit a double, and he stayed in, and then they tried to score him. To me that was fun. He stayed out there, and then they wound him home, and he didn't make it, and he made a great slide and tried to get in there. But to me that makes me a fan of him. You know, he's a baseball player. Right. It was fun.
Yeah, well, you know that play stirred up a little bit of controversy.
I'm sure it did.
Yeah, a little bit of anger with the third base coach Gary Jones for having sent Arrieta for a couple reasons. You know that you have a guy who's puffing and puffing around the bases and he's your best pitcher, and then you've got that potential collision at the plate.
Yeah. You know? Well,
that's why I thought it was all
aggressive baseball.
It made it fun, and to me, I was thinking to myself that Arrieta was. Look at him going to third, going, hey, man, I'm scoring. I'm a baseball player. I'm turning this and going.
Yeah.
It was fun, I thought.
He was all for it. It just scared the hell out of Cubs Nation, that's all.
It was fun.
Mark, real quick, you probably don't do what we do. I mean, we show up, you know, some of us show up about 5 minutes before showtime and do willy-nilly. What's the day in the life of Mark Grote? You got a 1:20 baseball game. What time are you getting to the field, and are you, you know, what kind of research are you doing to get ready for the game?
I don't do a damn thing.
Yeah. Hey, you want to be on our show?
I sleep in. We stay at these luxurious hotels. I'm late for my spa right now. Absolutely ridiculous. No, I mean, honestly, the day in the life is usually, you know, get up early, go find popular coffee shop, have coffee, do a little prep work, maybe get a workout in. And then the buses usually roll out to the park about 4 or 5 hours ahead of time. And then you just kind of go talk to the players in the clubhouse and then put together the pregame show and just kind of see where the day takes you.
That's fun.
Well, we did watch you the other night on Sports Talk Live on Comcast. Jim said he was tuning in, and Jim was kind of, he bared the question before the show started. Are you a diehard Cub fan, or if the Cardinals threw you a offer you couldn't refuse, would you go down to the Lou?
It changed your life.
Now, this can't answer that on the radio.
This is from Jim Ash.
Yeah. Hey, are you having trouble hearing us? Well,
this is straight from Jim Ash.
We're talking about it. If we can get me into the seven-figure category, I would go anywhere. $4 million.
That was my thought as well. If they're throwing him out the right numbers, he doesn't care what city. He'd be going to Mexico for all he cares. You
know, Jim was just doing some soccer. Maybe Jim's planning on bringing you on the show with us. I don't know.
I don't know what you're making, but we make a lot of money here at this show.
Yeah, come join you guys for
a meal. Exactly right.
That's right.
Hey, what's your stopping place for food up there in Milwaukee?
Well, actually, we're getting ready right now, as a matter of fact. I haven't really gone too far, but we're going down to a little cafe that is in the hotel that we stay in, a haunted hotel. I'm trying to think of the name of the... There's some steak joint, was it Lowe's or something like that? I can't think of it. There's a really nice steak joint that one of our broadcast partners, Ron Coomer, is supposed to take us to. Moe's, it's called.
Oh, get over to Moe's. I love Moe's.
Yeah. Moe's is the place. I haven't been there yet. So
I got the glass really, right in the freezer.
I haven't been very adventurous yet in Milwaukee, so we'll find out. Next time I talk to you guys, I'll have a better scouting report on the food.
Perfect.
My son lived in Milwaukee.
That's what I need.
My son lived in Milwaukee for a while. We went to Moe's a lot. Moe's is a good place.
All right. That's what I've heard, yeah.
Tell them Joe Ryan sent you. They'll hook you right up.
I'm going to care.
Mark, thanks for taking some time this morning to talk with us. We always appreciate it, and good luck. What is it, a 1:20 game today, or is it afternoon?
No, it's a 6:05
oh,
game.
Well, oh,
yeah.
You got all kinds of time.
You were serious about that spa
right
thing.
I'd be in a lot of trouble right now. If
oh. Oh, well, yeah. we wouldn't want that. All right, Mark, thanks for calling in, and we will talk to you down the road.
All right, boys.
Yeah. Yep. Go Cubs.
Bye-bye. Mark Grote.
Did you just say go Cubs?
Yeah, he did.
What is wrong with you?
Why wouldn't we?
He's in the moment.
Something wrong with that kid.
All right.
Oh, stop there. That. Whatever you just did, don't do that again.
Don't do what? Put the hat on him?
Hey. Well, we just talked about it. King of the Cubs,
yeah,
man. Go Cubs.
Yeah, that sounds like a pretty exciting life, man. You just hang out in a hotel and, you know.
He doesn't do jazz.
He just like the furniture guy.
He don't do a damn thing, he says. Well, we all know that's true. If you guys have ever listened to the pregame, postgame, he's a very knowledgeable guy, and I tell you, he makes it interesting, too. It's, you know, he puts his little spin on it, and he's fun to listen to.
Excellent job.
Well, hey, let's take a commercial break. We come back. We're going to talk about some NFL because it's training camp right around the corner. Peanut Tillman retires. Congratulations to @iNeitzel33. We're assuming that's Ian Neitzel. He's the winner of the McDonald's cheeseburger and cone. Pick those up at Jake's as well.
I bet he gets them both at the same time.
Oh, well, why wouldn't you?
Why wouldn't you? Yeah, so let's take a commercial break. We come back after these messages.
Some more of your stuff.
What did you do? Is that Jack?
What did you do?
What is that?
Did you give him his iPod? Did you give Jim your iPod?
No, that's not on my iPod.
Oh, I thought maybe.
That's not even my music. Taste.
You play that on the drums?
You
know
that?
No.
I knew you couldn't keep up.
Get a synthesizer. Welcome back to Cheap Seats on 96.3 FM. You know what? We know what we're going to do right now, real quick. We are going to do our favorite segment, and we are going to do. Hats off. Hats off.
Hats off.
Hats off. And my hats off this week is going to go to Charles Peanut Tillman. 13 years in the NFL. He's going to retire, or he did retire. He signed a one-day contract with the Bears yesterday. Retired as a Bear. So hats off to Peanut Tillman. Now, I played with Carolina Panthers last year. Almost got him a Super Bowl. Fell a little bit short to the Denver Broncos. So my hats off goes to Charles Peanut Tillman.
Nice job. Good hats off.
Thank you.
My hats off will go to the sweetest swing in baseball history.
And that would be Ken Griffey Jr.
Going into the Hall of Fame with Mr. Mike Piazza, probably the greatest hitting catcher of all time.
Absolutely.
What a combo.
So, hats off to him.
Ken Griffey Jr.
And?
No, I'm not going to
put him in? You just kind of tied it together?
I just tied it together because they're together in the induction.
Copy that. All right, Joe?
My hat's off would be to Roy Jetstream Green getting inducted into the Ring of Honor for the Arizona Cardinals. The first original two-way player in the NFL.
Can you please hats off to somebody that we know?
No.
Oh, man, look him up on the internet, Roy Jetstream Green.
Do you know who he is?
Two-way star in the NFL, averaged 100 plays a game. You guys all think it's Deion Sanders? It's Jetstream Green. And he'll be in October. They're going to put him in the ring down there in Arizona, home of America's team, Arizona Cardinals, probably the favorites to win the Super Bowl this year. They were going to be the first home team to ever win the Super Bowl.
No, they will
be. Until they got banged up.
They will be.
They're banged up every year.
Where's the Super Bowl this year?
It's not in Arizona. Don't worry about it.
Well, they won't be the home team, but they're still winning it. They have to be the favorites out there. Does Brady have to sit for four games?
Yeah.
Oh, that'll be scary. He'll be healthy.
Well, the dude from
he'll be healthy week five.
The guy from EIU is going to get a chance.
Garoppolo.
So
we have two EIU quarterbacks starting in the NFL.
We'll see.
Cowboys, Tony Romo and
Garoppolo. That's good.
That is good. That's good stuff.
And if you guys need any big red gear, jump on the internet, fanfare, and get yourself some. Arizona Cardinal gear.
Joe Ryan, Country Financial, stop on in.
Sponsored by.
Get on the wagon.
All right, back to the Peanut Tillman thing. He retires. Is he a Hall of Famer?
No. No.
Honestly, it's hard for me to say Hall of Famer for any other sport other than baseball because baseball, it's a little more strict.
Right.
So I don't really understand what the criteria is for football. Well, it seems like...
Yeah,
it seems like. I mean, he was tough defensively. I mean, and he forced a lot of fumbles and that kind of stuff. I mean, he was out there for many years every game. But
now he is. He will be in the Ring of Honor for the Bears. He's the best cornerback of all time for Chicago. But as far as Hall of Famer, I'm going to say no, just because of the different categories.
He's the best corner of all time
for Chicago.
Yeah,
I would. Yeah. Huh? Who else are you going to match him up to? I mean,
I'm
Gary Fensick.
He was a safety.
Doug Plank.
He was a free safety.
All right.
Keep going.
I'm just trying to figure some guys out for you.
Well, you can't.
Those guys had to be better hitters than him. But probably
Peanut had the peanut punch.
Yeah.
How many fumbles did he force and stuff like that? I mean,
I agree. I guess he was solid.
He wasn't the typical lockdown corner.
No, he wasn't a Deion Sanders.
But I mean, he was a smart
Deion's
player.
Deion's overrated.
Yeah,
Deion.
He's overrated.
10,000.
Deion never made a tackle.
TD
didn't have to.
Interceptions for touchdowns. I mean, that guy was crazy. Yeah. He didn't throw his direction.
Yeah, he's a great athlete.
I mean, he was faster than almost every wide receiver to play the game.
Yeah, he was an unbelievable athlete. I'll give him that. Hey, I want to go back to a baseball question here and show my ignorance or ask a question.
You think the Cubs will get off Ubaldo Jimenez?
Obama?
Who?
He's retiring this year, isn't he?
Jimenez from the Orioles. I think he's the starting pitcher Grody's thinking of that's coming over.
Let me ask you a question, though. Is it for a Major League Baseball team, like you talk about the Cubs wearing down and this and as they start the run, is it – I don't see this very often, so you guys tell me why. Wouldn't you think that the reserves on – let's go with the Cubs. Are the reserve outfielders or catcher or – I mean, they got to be pretty good ball players. I mean, they're playing Major League Baseball. If you're in that game and it's 9-1 and you're in the seventh and you're up 9-1, why don't you see those teams just say, hey, you know what? Why don't you three take a break, get over here in the shade, and we're going to run three more out there and give you guys a break to save the wear and tear? You know what I'm saying? Why don't you see someone do that? It never happens.
I don't think it's once you get the motor going, man. It's the same thing with football.
I'm totally against it in football, but football's an even more injury prone.
Correct.
Game.
But, you know, once you cool down, or once you heat up, you're good as long as you keep going.
Mm-hmm.
Once you take that break and you cool down, that's when things usually start happening.
And that's when you'll see a lot of managers towards this in the second half start giving guys rest. He just gave Zobrist 2 days rest after the All-Star break because it gives him a little boost, you know, that little refresher. Like we said before, the Cubs played at 24 days without a break.
Yes, that's a lot.
You know, you work 2 days a week and get 5 days off. You get rejuvenated. Jake, you work 4 days a week.
You think Jake works twice as much as I do? That's incredible.
3 days. 3 days. Four, and you get four off.
That's
you get
incredible.
Rejuvenated. You know, these guys are going out. Yeah, they're just playing baseball. But, I mean, baseball's a lot mental, too. And you just need that break. And you see it right now. They had the All-Star break, and then, you know, they come in rejuvenated. And
you got to take the break. You got to take a break,
you
man.
Start the long – I just don't see why you – if you're trying to
– I agree with, like, the – especially the catchers.
Yeah, they will do that.
That could be huge to get an extra three innings off.
Yeah. Well, and plus you're getting those three guys. If they played the last two innings in the game, you're already up 9-1. Gosh, you know what? If your relievers can't save that game,
the problem is I don't know how many games there are like that.
Well,
where you're like, you know what? Let's give this guy the rest of the game off.
Plus you're gonna get those guys more at bats. Maybe you may need them when the playoffs come.
The better thing to do for most of the position players outside of catcher, in my opinion, would be to say, hey, come in tomorrow, don't put your cleats on. Mm-hmm. You know, you got the day off. Yeah, we're not. But I mean, you know, it may be a pinch hit situation later, but
you're not,
you know what I'm saying?
Them.
You're not going to play. You're taking him out of the game. You want him to mentally walk away from it that day and just, you know.
But be on standby, you know, if we need to pinch hit.
Check in. I wonder about it all the time in NFL games. Why would a quarterback stay in that game? Why would a running back run the ball in the middle? I mean, just
it's repetition.
Well, in what you're saying, though, right now the Cubs' leading hitter is batting under 290. You know, and then you drop down to 250 right soon after that. That has to be a little bit worrisome, and then I think that's, again, touching on giving Zobrist a couple extra days.
Yeah,
he's a 300 hitter when he's going, and earlier in the season he was. Usually he has a slow start and then he kicks it into gear. Well, this year he started off pretty hot.
Well, you know, when you go to a new team, you do get re-energized, rejuvenated a little bit. Maybe that had something to do with it. And now that we are deep into the second half, it's, you know, these guys are going to get a little more rest. Your Zobrist, your Molina's, he's going to, you know, have to have some days off because, you know,
it's tough to give that guy a day off.
Yeah, I mean, if he's not in there.
Well, he fights for it, too. Right. I mean, he wants to be in there.
He does, but he's not getting any younger, and he's up there where, like you said, the catchers, you know, give him an inning or two off a night if they're up, you know. But you always want his leadership on the diamond, you know, his catching abilities. You know, he can throw out runners. I don't know what you have for a backup.
Well, and then also just controlling the pitching staff as well.
Well, what was your opinion the other day when Arrieta stayed in at second?
Arrieta's an athlete.
He's an athlete.
If I'm the third base coach.
They should not have sent him home.
Hey, well, you know, no, they shouldn't have.
No, they should not have sent him.
They did.
It was fun. I'm going to tell you what. Then they lost the game. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, give you an idea. Leg sweep by the catcher trying to, you know, not block the play because he can't technically do that. But they do that.
But if he scores, sure.
If he breaks that finger,
there's a lot of things that can go wrong.
Yeah, 2 months.
What it could have, should have. I mean,
I thought it was fun, but the whole time I was looking at it going, wow, Cub fans can't
but,
like this.
You know, they're out there to win the game. You know, it took a good throw to get him.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, if they score that
happens in baseball.
Yeah, it does. And, you know, you got to be aggressive. You can't really depend on.
No, you don't.
You
don't have to be aggressive with your ace.
You think if he tweaked a finger or something there and couldn't pitch,
there's
a third base coach fired. So, yeah, okay.
There is no argument.
Third base coach.
It was ignorance.
Whatever. Maybe you should go coach the Cardinals. On third base.
Take pay cut.
Probably
have to work off.
You have to work 5 days a week.
It's hot out there on third base.
They don't bring you water either. Like, you're sitting there begging for it.
You got to walk all the way out there yourself. They don't take you out a golf cart.
They don't even have
a
golf cart. Yeah. I don't know about this gig, man.
If you're away, you're fine because you're just right there.
Tommy Lasorda in the, what was it, the All-Star game? The bat slips out of the guy's hand. Yeah. Gets him.
The guy's 95 years old, yeah.
I understand. But,
yeah.
Help. Just wondered.
All right. Joe, you got something there you want to announce?
I'll tell you what, next week, we're not exactly sure where we're going to be, but we, Lincoln has a semi-pro basketball team in town, the Lincoln Lions. And I was taking a look at this logo, very interesting logo they have, if you haven't seen it yet. Maybe we'll put that on the website.
Is that Elvis?
It's very interesting. A split of an Abe and a Lion.
Oh. Yeah, I got a couple Lincoln high school grads on the team.
Josh Sutton's on there and Christian Van Hook's on there. They play a schedule. I don't know, it looks like maybe a 12-game schedule. Anyway, they want to come around, be on the radio, tell us about it. They have some T-shirts to sell and do some stuff. So I thought maybe next week we're going to have them on.
Well, it says here we're at Jake's next week. Is that true?
Is that true?
That's what they.
All right.
Whatever the paper says.
Yes, we are.
True.
Yes.
It's like Facebook. You know, if it's on Facebook, it's true.
So if you want to come out next week and see these guys, visit,
what,
maybe grab a
that's hard on a guy.
A T-shirt, help support them. There you go, the Lincoln Lions. And look at that logo. Have you seen it? It's very interesting.
Yeah, that's
funny.
Yeah, it's good
nice
stuff.
Nice cross, whoever thought
that's
of that.
It.
Nice cross there. That's something Loin would come up with.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe Loin can come up with a
Loin, could
song
you put all three of our faces together and make it an emblem?
That would just look like a blob.
I tell you
look
what,
at him. I could.
That looks like some that line there looks like it could eat some fish.
Yeah, I know what. Probably.
I tried to serve it up for
him.
Yeah,
you did.
Yep, end of the net. Yeah. Fault.
Wrong one.
Yeah. Well, that's going to do it for us.
The
10 o'clock on the dot. I'd like to thank Mark Grote for calling in today. You know, it's always interesting when he calls. The guy is
it's always better than listening to us.
Absolutely. Congratulations to Steve Ferris. He'll be at Knights Action Park if anybody would like to join him.
With Jason Washam.
Ian Neitzel. I guess it's Ian. It's I Neitzel 33. Yeah. He's the winner of the cheeseburger and the free cone, which Joe says, hey, you might as well get
them both. Get them both if you're there.
And I'd like to thank the Hampton Inn for the coffee and the pastries. That's always delicious. You can always catch our broadcast on LCTV Channel 5 in Lincoln and Mount Pulaski. You can go to WLCNonline.com, too, and watch any of our shows, as well as YouTube. Next week, we're going to be at the Jake's.
The Jake's.
And we're going to be selling some stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Don't forget, Jake, be early.
Bring your truck, bring a trailer, and we will fill that thing up. All right, that's going to do it for us, fellas. Scott Kirby, Jake Johnston, Joe Ryan with you. Until next week.
Good day.